Look at the stars, look how they shine for you. No. Everyone, this is a video lesson on the song Yellow by Coldplay. This lesson is only going to cover the acoustic part of the song, the way Chris Martin plays it live on stage and the way it sounds on the record. So if you want to play the song the way it should, stay tuned. Here it is. You need your guitar in a different kind of tuning, but it's not that hard. Only two strings are tuned differently, which is your regular D string, the fourth string. And note that I'm counting from the highest string. This is string number one. One, two, three, four, five, six. So your fourth string, which normally would be a D, is now a B. So you can play fret number 2 on the A string, and that should sound the same as the open 4th string. And the other string you need to tune down is the E, your first string. That should be a D sharp. So if you play fret number 4 on the B string, that should be the same as your first string. So now your guitar is tuned like this. E, A, B, G, B, and D sharp. Okay, if you're all set, let's go. So the first chord is called the B, and you play it like this. Your thumb plays fret 7 on the E string, so the 6th. Your ring finger plays fret 9 on the 5th. Your index finger plays fret 7 on the 4th. And your middle finger plays fret 8 on the 3rd. The bottom two strings are open. So this can be quite a difficult grip for some guys. I saw quite some tabs where this chord was shown like this, with an open fourth string. But if you check out live, you see him playing the chord like this. There isn't a big fundamental difference between this chord and this chord. But since I'm doing it, I want to do it right. But if you think this is too hard, you can just omit the fourth string and play the open string, the open B. But from now on, I'm gonna play this chord like this. Because Chris does it too, and he's my role model. And the strumming pattern is just down, and it's about the accents. Down, 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 down. So on that note, there's an accent. One and two and. On the two and. One and two and. Three and four. And after the four and, you play it down, up. Four and. One and two and. Three and four. One and two and. And after the second two and, the second bar, you make it a B at 11. Which is just adding your pinky on the third string on fret 9. So. And the strumming pattern is the same as in the first bar. So just 8 times down and then adding one up at the end. So after the intro, there's this electrical guitar theme. I'm gonna skip that because it uses the same chords as in the verse. So I'm just starting at the verse, but you can think of it as being the electrical part as well. So the first chord again is the B chord. Look at the stars. And there he omits the down up, so he just plays 8 down strokes in one bar, and each chord is played 2 bars, so it's 16 times down on each chord. And if you want to count with it, you should do it like this: 1 and So after we play the B chord for 2 bars, we go to an F sharp 6. So this chord is played like this. Your thumb goes on the 2nd fret of the 6th string. Your ring finger on the 5th, on the 4th fret, so the 5th string, 4th fret. Your pinky plays the 4th string, 4th fret. Ring finger plays the 3rd string, 3rd fret. Your index finger plays the 2nd string, 2nd fret. So it's thumb, ring, pinky, middle, index. And the first string, the D sharp, is open. And this chord is called an F sharp 6. An F sharp chord with an added 6 in the chord. Those are the 6s, D sharp. Okay, and we play this chord 2 bars as well, so 16 times down. So from the beginning it sounds like this. And then we go to the next chord, which is an E major 7, and it's probably the most easy chord in this song. It's just your E shape without your ring finger. So the middle finger plays fret 2 on the 5th, and your index finger plays fret 1 on the 3rd string. Beautiful chord. So it's rich and... yes, nice. So this chord is played 2 bars as well. And then you go back to the B chord. Note that there are 6 bars in one pattern, not 8 or 4, but 6. So the verse sounds like this. So and then just before we go to the chorus, you play the intro again. So the B, B at 11. But now the change is on the first bar beat of the bar. 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3, 4. And now we go to the chorus, and the chorus starts off with E chord, the E major 7, but one big difference: he plays the notes he frets 1 octave higher. And 1 octave on a guitar is pretty simple, just 12 frets up, and that is what he does as well. You can see it live, so you can just play with your middle finger and index finger. I think that's the easiest way to play it. So it's fret number 14 on the 5th and fret number 13 on the 3rd. So it's like this. And then he continues with the regular E major 7 chord over here. So it's just the first time he plays the chorus. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the next chord is an A flat minor. In the A flat minor, he plays like this: your thumb on the 4th fret of the 6th string, your ring finger on the 6th fret of the 5th, the D string, which is now a B, is open, and your index finger plays fret 4 on the 3rd string. So it's 4, 6, open, 4, open, open. And this chord is only played strum 3 times, so it's 1, and on the 2 and you change to the F sharp 6. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and you're So that's the chorus played three times. And then you end on E. I love you so, and back to B. So you end on E, and you play it one time. It's in the break, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4. You know I love you so. Back to the main riff. And the ending is played with one different chord. It starts in the B chord. We play it two bars, B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we go to F sharp minor at 11, which is played like this. Your middle finger on fret 2, your ring finger and your pinky on fret 2 on strings 4 and 3, and your index finger plays fret 1 on the first string. And of course you can use your thumb instead of your middle finger on the sixth string as well. But then I would play it like this. So the ending sounds like this. That's your acoustic part of the song Yellow. So, I advise you to play the song like this because you get the most accurate sound. I hope you enjoyed this lesson. If you did, please, what am I gonna say? Like this video and subscribe to my channel. Wow, you did not know I was gonna say that, didn't you? Okay, have a nice day and see you hopefully next time with another video. Bye bye, have a nice day, cheers.